For me, it's the most challenge, you know, that how to create the food from what we have now. Because we have so many kind of spices and so many kind of ingredients. We have a knowledge already. We have a basic knowledge. You have to choose a good material. You have to cook by the heart as well. If you don't cook by the heart, believe me, your food will be not like what you expect. How to create the food from what we have? Then how to surprise the customer when we make the food? Not just a copy from the book, but when we see some ingredient, we know what to do. That's the most important thing. Sometimes the people don't like it, but most of the customer will like it very much and appreciate what we did. The most important thing, we serve to the people with the heart. So 10 serve together is not easy to organize, but when we cook together, we put our heart together, I really believe that the food will be great. Well, selamat makan. Enjoy your food. I will see you around. Bye-bye.
I've been here for just over 2 years. And the product that was available 2 years ago compared to the product that's available now, as well as the chefs and restaurants. I mean, everything just keeps getting better and better. I could definitely see Bali becoming a culinary destination in the next 3 to 5 years. I had no idea when I moved here that so much product would be available. So, you know, the produce that's grown on the island is amazing. Obviously, the seafood is amazing. And then in addition to what I can get on the island or within Indonesia, I can import anything I want from Australia, from Europe, from the US. So I mean, there's no boundaries there. And you know, I haven't really forfeited or surrendered anything with what I like to work with. At one point or another, I can work with whatever ingredients I want. And a lot of, I think, expat posts, you can't do that. I've been cooking my whole life, and to me, food is life. You know, I know a lot of people that don't feel that way, but most of them do, the ones that I associate myself with. There's infinite possibilities. So with that, it's like, it's something that every day you can teach yourself something new, you can have fun with it. And, you know, it's nice getting people's reactions. Because, I mean, essentially all I do is I cook what I like. What excites me is what I cook.
A chef adapts to the country he's in. Now, when I first came to Asia, I never thought I would do hints of Asian food using Asian produce and Asian spices in my cooking. Now, over the last few years, I have slowly started to do that. But I think a chef adapts to the availability of ingredients and his environment. The most pleasurable times I have at work is when I have a full restaurant and it's really busy and all the orders are coming in, and it's a rush. It's that thing you can't explain. It's that one thing in everybody's life that they really love to do, and mine is to cook and to have that thrill of a really busy service. The first thing you have to work out is your customer needs, but after that, I believe you have to cook for yourself as a chef. Cooking is about a chef's own passion. Everything on my menu is something I would personally love to eat. I don't cook anything that I would not eat myself, or anything that doesn't interest me.
Thank you. Yeah, wine and food is actually, it's a marriage together. Yeah, so you have to have, if you have good food and a good wine, it enhances actually both. You have a good wine, what fits to the food, it brings out flavors, what you normally wouldn't taste if you would drink it without wine. And so the other way around. All the ingredients you can find here in Indonesia, Bali, it reflects on the food, sure, what I'm doing. Combining Western cooking methods with spices and ingredients from this country. So it gives you a wide spectrum to create new things. Yeah. Cooking is my hobby, so I'm doing it during my job. And the rest of the time I'm spending with my family, with my kids. So that's the most important for me. Okay, I hope you enjoy the evening, the good food and the good wine and the company.
I only wanted to be a cook because at school in the cooking classes was all the girls. So that was the most important class for me to be in, and that sort of started my passion for food. Oh, I think it's really, really important to have a passion for what I do, and my passion is cooking, my passion is food. And to be able to travel around the globe and work with so many different cooks and chefs around the world, as I'm doing tonight, as you're watching at the Ritz-Carlton, I think it's a fantastic opportunity for me to talk to people about food and, you know, cross my passion with those other people. So what people are going to try tonight is I've actually conned 100 barramundi to swim up here and join me on vacation, but they don't know they're coming up to be eaten at the dinner tonight for everybody here. So we're going to lop some fillets off and we're going to cut up some small portions, and we're going to serve the barramundi, which is an indigenous fish to Australia, with a lemon aspen butter sauce. And lemon aspen is one of the wild fruits of the Aboriginal people. My cooking has always been about looking for different tastes and flavours. And I've utilised a lot of Australian ingredients, our beef and our lamb, which I think is fantastic, our fish and our seafood, but using some of the flavours that the Aboriginal people have been eating for thousands of years. And I think that adds another dimension to my food. So it's being able to bring those flavours forward and create a cuisine which I think is uniquely Australian and hopefully uniquely my own. Yeah, I'm going home tomorrow, so I'm very disappointed, but I really hope you enjoy the fish dish. As I said, anybody with any complaints, please talk to my daughter Caitlin. Any compliments, I'm willing to take them anytime, but enjoy the fish dish. I hope you enjoy the whole evening, because Bali's a fantastic place, and thank you to the BCP for inviting me up here.
I born in a kitchen, almost, because my father is a chef. My grandfather was a chef. I had two uncle chefs. So it's part of our blood. So passion, feeling, it's part of my education.
You need to have a nightlife, rock and roll, passion, and a bit crazy. You need to be a bit crazy to be a chef because we work a long hour and we need to give the power to the guys in the kitchen because it's not only us and cooking, it's not only me, also for all the chefs in the world. We are not magicians. We are not like that, the food. No, no, they need to have some people behind. And the people behind, they learn with me and we teach each other and we get some different ideas. So that makes the connection. It's already fashion, the Balinese style, because all the chefs, the fashion chef or the fusion chef, they use this type of ingredient and this type of food to realize something new. And all of the world, they do this, they start to copy, or they start to take some idea from everywhere. So Bali is part of the international cooking. Thank you to the service staff and all the sponsors. That's all. Thank you so much.
My food is my life, it's not a job. It's what I do. I've been traveling and I guess cooking for a long time and eating for even longer. So it's something that I really enjoy. I've traveled all over the world and I guess all of my memories involve food of some sort or eating somewhere. So yeah, it's a life for me. I think the most important thing, there's two things. Everyone who eats is a food critic. Everyone's going to have their own opinion on what's good and what's bad food. For me, it has to reflect where you are. It has to be using local ingredients. So there's no point living in Bali and having Dover sole on your menu, for instance. It needs to be local to make it special. I don't really have a technique. I cook what I like to eat, I think, and I'm strongly influenced by where I am at the time when I write a menu. For me, my food is reflected by where I am, so I tend to take on whatever is around me, but there's definitely a strong influence.
when I create something new, is it doesn't matter, is it a wedding cake, is it some dessert or just a simple cake, when I create something new, in the first time, I like it.